PoPolitickin.com.
Hey, yo, what's up with it? This your boy, Young Bleed, and we on PoPolitickin. Make sure y'all download, like, and subscribe. You hear me? Yes, sir.
Yeah, I train. Yeah. I'm supposed to stop, but I can't. Huh? I'm a dog. Yeah. I love hoes. Yeah. And I'm addicted to money, cars, and clothes. Do it big.
PoPolitickin.com. Make sure you subscribe to us on YouTube and iTunes, and get the app. We on iTunes and Android. I'm now politicking with my homie Young Bleed. How you doing?
I'm pretty good, man. Passing through like I do. What's good with you?
I say you still fly the eagle and see no evil. That's still like you get man, down.
Just got off the eagle, man. Just fresh out the plane, man. Coming in from off the show from. No, Tuscaloosa, Alabama last night, just getting back to Michigan. So, yeah, man, all day flat, man, every day.
All right. So can we just, I want to just give us a journey, man. So we just want to start from the beginning, man. So the first time I heard about you, you know, was back in the day when How You Do That, Dad, My Balls, My Words CD came out. So can you just give us a background, like how you got into music, how long you been doing it?
Yeah, man. Going back to what you just mentioned, yeah, like 97 when Pete was doing Master Pete, for those that don't know, but, and, you know, No Limit, at the time was doing that Body movie, man, and I had an opportunity in 97 to put on, you know, actually put a remix of it on the soundtrack. But before then, before I'm getting to that, and actually 20 years this year, 97, no, 2017, so that's 20 years ago, man, history in the making. But before that, I come from an origin and a population called the concentration camp based out of Baton Rouge on a homie of mine by the name of C. Lope. We grew up together, actually. You know, I've been doing this as a kid since like age three. You know, for the penmanship, so me and Lope somewhere like 85, 86, you know, coming to each other middle school ways. And, you know, he actually used to be my DJ back in the gap when he was a kid. But we all grew up with that rap dream, and I was able to, I put out a tape that I used to sell in the neighborhood and high schools and surrounding area, mom and pop stores and corner stores. That I had a couple of songs, and my first song hit the radio between the time I was about 16, 17. So that was going on in Baton Rouge around those, the middle 80s into the 90s, and like I say, more recent, about 97, yeah, my homie had the label C-Lo Records. We had concentration camp on C-Lo, the master, he clicked up some kind of way. They got together, and we started working together. Like I say, just being blessed, man, it was just perfect timing, and movie and everything. Real was taking off, and all of us just happened to be, you know, get a part of that same train that led out to California, of course, and priority rep. And we ended up going with the world, not the most from you. It's the How You Do That joint, really the remix, the original joint on a self-titled concentration camp, first concentration camp album that originally called The Fool, you know what I mean? And pretty much what I'm saying at the end of the verse, make them act a fool. But when people heard the hook, you know, the world kind of ran with that, and at least locally and in our southern region. And by the time No Limit got it, you know, the world, well, everybody thought the song was called How You Do That. So we went with it, you know what I mean? Pretty much the rest is history, you know what I mean? If I get a case in point on that No Limit evolution, call all the rappers, see love rappers in the concentration camp. But yeah, you know what I mean? Life goes on beyond that point, but I'll let you take it from there. We'll do it a little bit at a time.
Yeah. So who I guess who were some of your influences when you came up? Who you like to listen to? Who you used to listen to?
Oh man, nowadays is almost infinite. But for starters, in the '80s, and you know, with New York kind of being the mecca for hip hop in America, we all fought in New York in those eighties and maybe the late '70s. You know what I mean? Depending on how old an OG and how nick you was, you know, you might have been hearing music from New York and other parts of the country. In middle '70s, late '70s, before the evolution of hip hop. But for me, it was in that time. I'm a '70s baby, born in '74, so I grew right with it. And you know, we get was trickled down from up north on into the south. So as it was spread throughout the country, you know, I got the bug too, and I give credit to a lot. I mean, the farms of hip hop. When you go, you know, you mention that. So it's an infinite list, but of all time, Rakim always been my favorite rapper and lyricist. You know what I mean? I really studied Rakim deep as a kid, just his philosophy and vocabulary. And low key, and you know what I mean? Smooth persona. You know, LL and Daddy Kane, you know what I mean? So on and so forth. But I used to mimic LL Young in the Mirror, man, and you know, the way he had a rebel yell voice. And I had to figure out if he did a show all the time, you know, Mystical later on became one of those type of guys that got a yell pitch kind of voice. So I hear him come off stage and, you know what I mean, later in life, and, you know, battle the talk and got to get his voice back. So the same way was for me as LL, as, you know, mimicking LL as a kid in the mirror when my parents would leave home. I can't quite the stereo up, but yeah, I had that same kind of problem with my vocal tone. So, you know, guys like Rock, you have a low tone, and guys that kind of more spoken rap like they talk. You know, I felt in that pocket, but ready to go back to Ron DMC, the Sugar Hill Gang, man, Curtis Blow, you know what I mean, and rest in peace to my guy on beginning of hip hop, the group Nucleus, you know what I mean? He was, you know, pretty much father of, had the song called Jam On It, so that was like one of my favorite rap songs, you know what I mean? Zulu Nation, Africa Bound by the Soul Sonic Force, and, you know what I mean? Planet Rock, so, you know, it's an infinite list for me, because I'm old as hip hop, man, so I grew with each generation of it and up until now, so, you know, pretty much that.
Yeah, I'll say so. Yeah, like now, you know, we got the Kevin Gates and the Bootsies, Rick Rosses. So how you feel about the, I guess, the new South per se?
Well, it's family tree. When you say that, man, Bootsie is family, man. You know what I mean? Blood lineage, man. Same block, same hood. You know what I mean? I started the camp at that birth, Bootsie, later on with the concentration camp. I really started the camp. And low on delay, but I brought that idea to him, whether it's rappers like Max Minnelli, Jay Vaughn, Happy Perez, the producer, which was a group called Lalo at the time. That was some of my younger homies that we got together. We made backroom tapes where we stayed at each other's minds, talked, and we hang a mic from the ceiling and put a sock on it, and freestyle albums, infinite shit that I wish the world could hear now. You know what I mean? But Jack, back in our essence, and then later on, Boosie, you know what I mean? Naturally had to see that rise and my rise and be entitled to it, so he kind of come up the same path, you know what I mean? Just off the lineage. On it took Kevin Gates. Kevin Gates was sprung off a record label called Dead Gang, which is in the top of my neighborhood. I know the OGs and all that, all of the family, you know what I mean? So I know all them in the beginning. I know Gates, got records with Gates, Boosie, and, you know what I mean, Lee Webby. I worked at an apartment complex and knew him as a kid, but not directly, indirectly, but he had been a missing kid that was out there when I was working around. And by the time I met Webby later in life, and I just spoke with him, he'll call and holler at me every now and again, but I just spoke with him recently, and we always shared his story, you know, when he was a kid, it was some trouble that the kid was getting there, and I worked at the groundskeeper, this apartment complex, and, you know, he was one of the kids. I told him, hey, man, y'all better get the hell up out of here, so he worked for the police on y'all. So later in life, when he started to do records locally, I wanted to meet him, and then I finally got my opportunity to meet him, and I was like, nice to meet you, and he was like, hey, man, it's like the first time you met me. I say, how is this? So he said, I was one of those little kids, he told, get up out of here for these police cats, and y'all always remember that. So when he blew up, so yeah, as far as my origin and birthplace, Southside, Baton Rouge, and Baton Rouge as a whole, we all know each other and grew with each other. If not bloodline, we close enough to call each other that. So, yeah, a lot
familiar, man. Yeah, I was going to say, so, and then, like, a lot of, like, if you look online, it's a lot of articles, they put you in the list for, like, one of the top underrated artists, like, far as rappers. So, how you feel about that? Because you always come up in those lists. Like, a lot of people say you was underrated.
Right, right. Always been an underdog, always studied underdogs, man, until we, you know, finally triumph, you know, guys like Pac, or, you know, whoever that you saw in their rise. A lot of people got on Pac by the time he did All Eyes on Me, or, you know what I mean, Me Against the World, Morales, I was trying to say. But I remember Pac from Tupacalypse Now, you know what I mean, Strictly for My Niggas, and, you know what I mean, the whole thug like origin. So it's like, we all in this underground, and we bubbling, there's so much infinite talent out here, it's crazy. You know what I mean? But depending on what the individual and what the situation and, you know, what have we may be to each his own. So, like I said earlier, Rakim always been my one of my, you know, my favorite rappers, and eventually, you know, so on and so forth. So I can't even put it in a bundle and narrow it down to one. I heard Jay-Z say something in the interview one time that made the most sense in the world to me. He said, really, it's based on the pen. So, well, my favorite might not be your favorite, and as an individual, we had a right to that. So you can't really put it in a nutshell, you know what I mean? So, yeah, it go on and on, man. I'm glad to see it still continue to this day. When they thought, you know, rap was a fad, and it wouldn't last that long. So I was speaking this in another interview a few days ago, saying, as really in categories now, you know, rest in peace, Pimp C used to call it country rap songs, being in the South, and when they said we was country and couldn't rap, but we come up with our own terms. Okay, well, if it ain't hip-hop, to the West Coast, to some people, it's crip-hop, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So it's just where it ain't where you at, where you from, you know what I mean? I mean, it ain't where you from, it's where you at mentally, how you come at people. So it's all about disrespect. We got to learn to respect each other and different. So like I said, yeah, hard to put it all in a nutshell, but kind of, you know, basically that.
Okay, so and what you working on right now? Like, what projects you got going on?
Okay, well, you know, if you're not up on it, I just dropped a new album, man, titled Living February 10th, man, available anywhere digital, you know what I mean? And for those that want to, you know, rather get that hard copy purchase, man, go to www.trapdoorent.com. That's my own label, personal website, and so on and so forth for its merch. The book that I released years ago and different things like that. The newest videos, past videos, and, you know, what's up and coming, tour schedule, and so on and so forth. So tap into that. But at the same token, like I said, I'm just relaunching my label, Trap Door Entertainment. So I'm already working on this compilation that I plan on releasing in the next couple of months called Welcome to the Trap, to introduce some of the underground individual, you know, independent artists, more rap, I'm trying to say, on that particular compilation. Then followed it up close to the fall, end of the year, with another Bleed solo called The Legend of Bleed's Arrival, man. So I'm busy, man, getting ready to tour. We're really starting at the end of the week, man. I started a tour with some independent guys from around the country, man, called the Hard Work Pays Off Tour. That includes my guy, Mr. Chucky Workflows out of Indiana, my man, Mr. Envy out of Louisiana, my guy, the homie Jay out of Louisville, Kentucky, my man, Omega Legacy out of Tennessee, Nashville, I believe, Tennessee. That Nashville, so I might be saying that wrong. But Tennessee and my guy Psych Pacino out of Boston, man. So we all moving around and linking up with locals and other independent artists along the way and just mashing, you know what I mean, for the cash, man, making it do what it do, man, to continue to put the revenue where the revenue belongs, man, to keep the machine going for this. So, yeah, man, I'm staying busy. I got my hands in a whole lot of different things, you know, underground movies and so on and so forth. So, you know, keep your eyes and ears peeled. I mean, who knows, you know what I mean?
Yeah, and I was, I remember a little while ago, I thought you had a song with Rick Ross, so it was like rumors, everybody was thinking that you was going to sign with MMG, so are you with them, or, because you had a song with him, right?
I never had a song with Rick Ross. Freeway Rick is my guy, out there in California, you know what I mean? We was talking some things, and I had some records over there, probably his entourage. I did a record, actually, that, a guy by the name of Ike Burner had, that, I believe had 2 Chainz and Soulja Boy on it, you know what I mean? So maybe you're talking about that record, but nah, it's, I know Freeway Rick, I hadn't had the privilege to meet, Rick Ross the rapper.
All right. So if anybody, like you were saying, so you've been out for basically 20-plus years, but if there's any new artists that just now getting exposed to your music, where would you want them to start at? Like, what you got out now? You want them to go back from the old stuff? Where'd you want them to go?
Yeah, if I study anybody, man, it's like books, man. I want to go back to, like I just mentioned, with Pac Legacy a long time ago, and people that really caught on to Pac when I get around, got famous. I remember Pac from All Around the World, the same song with Digital Underground and from the movie Juice. A lot of people don't know this. It's Pop became a rapper. When you look, and if I'm not mistaken, but if you listen to that soundtrack, Juice, he didn't even have a rap song. You know what I mean? But for it's that. But yeah, the same way, man. Go back to the essence with me. Everything that I pre-mentioned is available YouTube or however on the internet for the concentration camp. You can see what was taking place around that time. You know what I mean? On up into the No Limit records, into my priority days, and all my independence from Selecto hits. Shouts out to my big bro Sebo and the West Coast Mafia. You know, out there. We make the big collab on records, and a whole lot of independent guys. I done did, everywhere I go to, I do features with the locals on up, man. So I got infinite records and still working every day. So yeah, start at the beginning, man, and catch up to me, man, and see where we go from there, you know.
And then I say, so I want you to talk about a little bit. So why is that important? Like you were saying, the work with the locals, wherever you had an independent artist.
Just to keep your feet in the ground, man, you know what I mean? Casey Kasem, you know what I mean? You say it the best. The voice is Shaggy from the original Scooby-Doo cartoon. Rest in peace for those that don't know who Casey Kasem is, but he used to have this top 10, I forget what kind of music, music segment or whatever used to come on, TV show used to come on back in the 80s or something like that. one of those guys. I'm just one that became famous and got a break. You know what I mean? Some of us get a break. Some of us, you know, don't, you know, unfortunately don't get a break. You know what I mean? But for those that know and that's on that same path, yeah, I passed down what I was passed down to keep the game going. So, yeah, it's a must to do that. I mean, when you're in Rome, you got to do what the Romans do. If I'm anywhere and I hadn't been before, I'd rather know somebody that could guide me through versus me jumping off blind. So I try to connect with somebody, you know what I mean, if I don't already have familiar there. So, yeah, keep it on the ground, man.
And what advice would you give to any independent artists out there trying to make a career out of music?
Basically this, I always say this, man, you know what I mean? For life lessons, man, always God first, man. Get yourself together, get right with God, get your mind right, you know, with life, your family, and, you know, whatever else it takes to keep you grounded and learn this business and master your craft, man, and that way you for sure a good thing, you know what I mean? It's all about quality versus the quantity. If something is good and it's marvel, I mean, any way you place a diamond in the world, a diamond gonna be a diamond. You know what I mean? So master your craft, man, and build yourself into that diamond, man. And when the time comes, hey, you're gonna be already set for your masses, you hear me?
And then do you got anything else, like any hobbies or interests outside of music you into?
Yeah, you know, I dabble in a little this, a little that. Like I say, I'm all behind the scenes, you know, working on a few B-level kind of movies and stuff like that. Just getting used to acting in that sense of the word. You know, I did videos throughout my whole career. You know what I mean? I got a couple that's on Vivo, man. For anybody that watches the Vivo on the YouTube channels, you know, I got different videos with, you know, infinite artists and so on and so forth. But, yeah, man, you know, I write sometimes, read, you know, natural thing, go fishing, you know what I mean? I'm a country boy from Louisiana, so I like, you know, I walk the sidewalk while you riding in the car just to breathe the fresh air. So I like, you know, I love life and love living life. So, you know, pretty much all of the above, man. Anything good, man, I'm trying to be a part of it, you know what I mean? In a weird set. Anyway.
All right, man, I just want to say thank you for coming through politicking with me. I really appreciate it. Like I said, I was a big No Limit fan growing up, so I'm going to get all y'all. Like I said, I already got Fiend, so got you.
Yes,
I'm going to get all y'all.
Okay, well, let me know who you may not be connected to. You know, me and a lot of those guys still hollering, of course, when we get a chance to do something with each other. It's still family. Everybody just got their own business, and, you know, when you're building an entourage like that, hopefully that's what everybody do. So we all just standing independently strong, man. Moby just produced and did a track, did a hook on the record we did called Karma Is For Real on the new album Living. So y'all check that out.
I say that's actually somebody I've been trying to get, because I think he slept. I don't think people even be noticing him, but I actually been trying to get him, Moby Dick.
Hey, look, when we hang up, man, I'm finna call Mo for you and swap y'all out. And there it is, you know. Like I said, we working on some things. He doing an album now that's soon to be released that I just did a nice feature and video with called Real Niggas, you know what I mean? That's coming out soon, so y'all stay tuned to that. I just talked to the rest of the Beast by the Pound guys, and I think they working on a documentary about, you know, this whole, you know, No Limit, and them being, you know what I mean, the beat mouse is kind of like Outkast just did with my guys organizing on.
Yeah,
and that same essence, yeah, it's a whole lot of stuff to come that's offering these records, you know what I mean? The world here, what we put out, we don't know the 200 or 1,000 records we make in the meanwhile, just processing, so everybody individually, so imagine that number. So it's a lot of stuff to come. But, yeah, I'll connect you with Mo, and just let me know, and I'll let you know who I might get my hands on, man, and put all that together. That's a beautiful thing. I appreciate you bringing us to the table like that.
Yeah, thank you, man. I was saying, you want to tell them how to hit you, like, what's your, you might already said it, but just your social media again, where they can hit you up, like producers hit you up, everything.
Yeah, man, for what it is on Facebook, man, that's so full, you know, you get the 5,000 on Facebook, it kind of stops. So I got fan pages, any of the fan pages, Young Bleed fan pages on Facebook. For my direct one, that's pretty much a fan page too, it's Glenn Clifton, which is my government, and Young Bleed's management. So, you know, you can find me there on Facebook. On Twitter, it's at Real Young Bleed. And on Instagram, it's the Real Young Bleed. So, enter that. You can find me all day. You know what I mean? LinkedIn, so on and so forth. I'm so spread on them, but at a constant level four is my daily. You know what I mean? PoPolitickin.com. Hey, yo, what's up with it? Bleed, and we on PoPolitick, and make sure y'all download, like, and subscribe. You hear me? Yes, sir.
Young Bleed.
I'm never worried about he say or she say. I'm living good as we flying by on the freeway. I'm feeling good, need to slow it down, take it easy. Stop through the hood, even though I'm living good.
That's right, I'm on some pimp and bomb. Some bun and pimp. I miss my nigga and his mama blowing tons of him. Sean Kemp in the game, get my funds and dip. I see the blip, ain't nothing change. I feel my lungs flip down trip.
Thanks for listening to PoPolitickin.com, a self-help meets hip-hop brand. If you are an artist or business owner wanting to be featured on PoPolitickin.com, contact us at PoPolitickin@gmail.com. That's PoPolitickin@gmail.com or text 760-717-5803. If you're a listener that enjoys the show and wants to support, you can donate to PoPolitickin.com via PayPal.com. Please send donations to PoPolitickin@gmail.com. Any amount will be helpful in continuing to create quality content and shows. As always, check out PoPolitickin.com for past episodes. Make sure you subscribe to PoPolitickin on iTunes, YouTube, Podomatic, Stitcher Radio, and Google Play.
Welcome to CoNimby Foundation, a private family foundation incorporated in 1968, and it's dedicated to our continued mission of reflecting the family philanthropic philosophy. Our programs expand educational opportunities and creative, inclusive communities, because supporting the causes of education and community development is the hallmark of our work. The Foundation's programs have ambitious goals that seek to meet the needs of our communities. We acknowledge how important it is to have sound structures and strategies in place to achieve success in all of our programs. To learn more about our work, visit us at conimby.org and on Facebook at CoNimby Foundation.